Sometimes faith is complete reliance in face of the intangible. Think about Moses. Moses had just been used of God to get the Israelites on their way out of Egypt. But then Pharaoh decides he doesn't want to let them go. So he's chasing them, and he chases them right into the Red Sea. What are they going to do? Well, God's got to do something, but God does not act until Moses lifts his hands in prayer over the Red Sea, and then God opens up the sea so that they can walk through. Sometimes God doesn't act until we take the first step, and then God does the God thing. Abraham, God called him and said, I'm going to give you a wonderful land, and I'm going to make you into a mighty nation. But none of that happened until after Abraham left his homeland, went 450 miles, went to the new land, set up his tents, and then God acted on Abraham's behalf. Think about Joshua. He's leading the children of Israel into the promised land, but there's a problem. There's the Jordan River, and it's at flood stage. What's he going to do? Well, God can do the miraculous, but God did not do the miraculous until the priest stepped into the water. And then God opened the water so that they could pass through on the other side. The most strategic city in Canaan land was Jericho, and it was the unbeatable city with massive walls. But God can knock those walls down, but God didn't knock those walls down until after they marched around for 7 days. Until after, on the seventh day, they marched around seven times and shouted and blew horns. And then God knocked the walls down so they could have a victory. Sometimes God does not act until we take our step of faith. Several years ago, as a pastor, we had a burden to reach a community area that we were not reaching. And we had a mailing all set up to go to that area, but it cost $10,000 that we didn't have. And I remember praying about it and really sensing this is what God wants us to do. So I gave the directive to go ahead and make it happen. Well, we didn't have the money. But when we took our step of faith, God stepped in. And a couple days later, we got a check in the mail from a family that had lived in that neighborhood, had moved out of the area, but wanted to they'd come to our church. God had blessed them. God had changed their lives. They moved out of the area. And so they sent a check back in gratitude for exactly $10,000. I don't know that they would have been burdened to send that check if we hadn't first taken our step of faith. There are things God is waiting to do for you, but he's waiting for you to make the next move. God is waiting for you to take your step of faith.